Boss said I can't bring in nice lunches anymore. So I work in a small office of like 15 people. I love to cook, but normally for lunch I just bring soup to try and lose weight or buy something from one of the places nearby. Anyway, my boss loves to cook as well, and it is a well-known secret that it puts her in a good mood. If you compliment her lunch, need to leave early? Wow, Karen, that salad looks delicious. Where did you get it? You made that? Wow. Then 5 minutes later, ask her to leave early and it's no problem. Now, I was very happy with this arrangement. But at lunch one day, she was giving out how ridiculous it is that all celebrity chefs are men and that it's sexist and that she would have a Michelin star if she were a man. I am one of three men who work in my office. I thought this was insane, since firstly she doesn't own a restaurant and secondly there are many female celebrity chefs, although the top three celebrity chefs who come to mind are definitely male. I ignored it because I wasn't going to call out my boss. But then she said, "Op gets it. I bet he couldn't reheat leftovers without his fiance." This was wildly disrespectful, wildly inappropriate and also incorrect. I told her I actually cook all the meals at home for my fiance and I. She laughed and said she feels sorry for my fiance then. I got mad but again said nothing. Instead, I started making lovely lunches. I'm a pretty great cook if I do say so myself. We all usually have lunch together and instantly I started getting compliments. Karen said nothing, but with every compliment she looked like she was sucking on a lemon. I started it out of spite and to prove a point, but seeing her reaction made me keep it up. After about a week, she called me into her office saying there had been complaints about my elaborate lunches, and I had to tone it down. I played dumb and just said I had started bringing in leftovers. She jumped on that and said, "Yeah, that's it. No more food from home." Again playing dumb, I said, "Okay, I guess. I'll tell the others no more food from home. We don't have a canteen." She panicked and said it was just me. I asked why and she fumbled, then said no one else had a complaint against them. I asked for it in writing and she declined, saying it was a personal matter. That's when I said, "If I don't have it in writing, I won't know what is acceptable," and left. Can you believe Dave just bringing in his elaborate lemon chicken risotto like that? If I see another garnish in the lunchroom, I'm gonna lose it. Wow, please begin bringing a cloth napkin, candlesticks and matches. Maybe a vase and a single rose. Is your boss going to compensate you for the cost of lunch then? You should ask. Sounds like you have to start ordering takeout and charging it to the company since she won't let you bring food in. Bury her. I hope to hear more, lol. I had something similar happen. I love to bake and I used to make stuff to bring into work for staff and patients during holidays on a semi-regular basis. Once or twice a month at most, and if it was someone's birthday and they were working, I would make a cake or cupcakes, as we had stopped doing that for people. One day my boss has this real sourpuss on her face and tells me I can't bring in baked goods anymore. She gave some lame excuse about how we weren't allowed to have anything on the unit that didn't come from the kitchen. So I was like, "Oh, I will just bring stuff in for staff then." "No, can't bring anything in." "Oh, okay." Shortly after, another coworker started bringing in more and more elaborate baked goods a couple of times a week. I was a little confused because my boss was super happy about it. I mean, they were really nice and I don't complain about free treats. So I said something to that coworker and got a vague, "Oh well, I didn't know that rule," from her. But then I found out from someone else that said coworker had complained to our boss that she couldn't bring stuff in because I was. Now, I wouldn't have done it so much. Except people really appreciated it. If she had said something, I would have stopped everything but cakes, cupcakes for birthdays, since She would never do that for some reason. I really didn't care. But later my boss basically yelled at me for being selfish. It's fine, lady. I don't need to bring in cookies. I did make pies for a couple of people who asked for them to take home, and got a talking to about doing business at work. I didn't get paid for said pies. Anyway, that coworker who was doing all the baking was basically using work to build up her business and quit suddenly when she had enough of that. Like no show, no call for days, and then finally texted someone, not even our boss, that she had quit, except she didn't tell anyone. No, I still don't bring anything in except for specific coworkers. There had been complaints about my elaborate lunches. I wouldn't have been able to keep from laughing. There are so many more things about me that are worth complaining about. No one would start with the food. There's no way I got away with everything except the fancy lunches. I'm off the clock on lunch. If you want to pay me to eat differently, that'll be $40 per hour with 2-hour minimum. Is your boss 15? Ask her if she is going to provide a $20 a day stipend for you to buy lunch every day. Pro tip: bring in some durian fruit. Crack that bad boy open right when everyone sits down to eat. I believe this. I used to make baklava, cookies, etc. and bring them to work. One snobby gal who was always rude to me would never take any. I found out from another coworker that she would grab some when I left the room, LMAO. I thought it was hysterical. You, my friend, are a champ. This has got to be one of the weirdest stories I've seen on here. TLDR, supervisors are stupid. I mean, she is actually correct about women chefs being underrepresented in the culinary world, but that's no reason for he launch into a sexist attack against you instead of supporting women chefs. I really want to know what these elaborate lunches were. I wish this was FanFIC. Some PPL really are the worst. Sounds like sexual discrimination to me. I'd report her to HR. I thought this was insane. Yes.
If you enjoyed this video, please check out our playlists full of similar content. Epicaracast is like doom scrolling for your ears. Please like, share, and subscribe.